What's up, everyone? Welcome to the bonus episode for Let's Play Bayonetta. Now, to start this off, we have a special hidden boss fight. Now, you might have remembered that I mentioned a very long time ago, back towards, I think, the beginning of the Let's Play, I was talking about the hierarchy of Laguna and all the different tiers to it. And there is the Auditio and then the Dea, but I mentioned that there is one right between the Dea and the Auditio. The Dea, of course, being occupied by the final boss of the game, Jubileus. Now, one tier below that is Father Rodin, the Infinite One. And this is a very, very cool, very fun boss fight. The entire boss fight takes place on nonstop infinite climax difficulty. That's not something that you can change. You can't fight him on normal difficulty. He's basically a hard mode only boss, and he is the strongest enemy in the entire game. Additionally, you can't do things like use lollipops, any sort of lollipop. You can't use the immunity ones, the attack power ones. You can't heal yourself. And Rodin, you see, moves very, very, very quickly. He attacks quickly and aggressively. And he does an enormous amount of damage. Individual hits with every witch heart in the game can take off close to a quarter of your health, not quite, maybe a fifth. If he combos you, he can take off a little over half health immediately. So the two accessories I'm using here, also because it's, I forgot to mention, because it's nonstop infinite climax only, you cannot activate Witch Time, he cannot be stunned. So the two accessories I'm using here are the Evil Harvest Rosary, which replaces my ability to activate Witch Time, but since we can't use that here anyway, what it does is whenever I dodge and whenever I would normally activate Witch Time, it leaves behind a little purple orb that explodes and does damage on impact. And it does a pretty significant amount of damage at that. So, to make up for the fact that I can't dodge and use Witch Time, I just have that accessory. My other accessory is the Climax Bracelet, which I think you have to unlock by playing on either on one of the harder difficulties. I think it might actually be non-stop infinite climax, or alternatively you can unlock it using the telephone booth cheat for I think it's 5 million halos. And of course the platinum ticket to get to Rodin costs 10 million, so if you're doing it this way it's going to cost you 15 million halos to unlock this boss. And what the climax bracelet does is it makes all of your attacks serious mode. And I don't think you have access to serious mode. You might actually, I don't remember. The climax bracelet might not be doing anything, but I just keep it on anyway. You may or may not be able to access serious mode, which makes all your attacks wicked weaves for this boss fight. And you can see this fight was going pretty well for me. I'm starting to take a little bit more damage here. Rodin, when he gets to this about this much health, he gets ridiculously aggressive. He gets about twice as aggressive, twice as fast, and a couple of his moves, projectiles in particular, he starts to throw out twice as many. Like here, the orbs, if you run into the orbs, you get stunned and you have to waggle out of it. But he'll normally just hit you. He'll normally just ruin your day. So there are a couple ways you can go about fighting him. That attack there where he charges you with his fist glowing, if he manages to catch up to you and grab you, he will drain you down to one health. And if you're already at one health, it will just kill you. So avoid that at all costs. You have to go into Beast Within to avoid that. He will catch up to you if otherwise. Even here when I'm using Odette in one of my slots, my Shirabo Odette slot, the alpha one, he'll still catch up to you. Oh, and this, so the fight was going pretty well, and then I made a little mistake and did the Shiraba, what was it called? The bullet climax, where she spins around instead of getting out of the way, instead of hit and running. And he took me down to literally one health. I dodged in midair and accidentally activated Crow Form, but the orb. So I was vulnerable sitting there in midair as a crow. But luckily, the evil harvest rosary finished him off. So I was talking about strategies for dealing with Father Rodin, the infinite one, and we're just going to buy up all the stuff in the shop because, hey, we have plenty of money left. One of the ways you can deal with him is you can get either Pillow Talk, which is a much stronger version of Shiraba. And you can use its charge attack. I can't remember how to unlock Pillow Talk, actually. It's pretty much a lightsaber. Either that or Shiraba. You charge Shiraba's R2 attack up. You charge Shiraba up, and whenever he gets close, you just let it rip. That can occasionally stagger him, and it'll leave him open for a follow-up, a stiletto, and maybe another one or two quick swipes. The cheesiest way you can handle that fight is to wait until he leaves himself open. When he fires the blue orb off, it will move 3 times towards you, and it'll cover a pretty good distance, but you can put a lot of space between you and Rodin, and it gives you time to pull out Kilgore. And if you're using the Climax Bracer, if you're in serious mode, Kilgore fires Wicked Weaves. Like, it's a projectile Wicked Weave. And it will stagger Rodin most of the time. Actually, it will stagger him any time it hits him. So you can put yourself in a situation where you can just spam Kilgore. You saw me do it a few hits in a row. I didn't want to abuse it too badly. You can spam Kilgore, and the Wicked Weave projectile will almost entirely lock him down. Sometimes he'll manage to get back in close to you enough to just hit you once, but usually you can still fire one off when he's in your face like that. And then the other way, you can just go hyper aggressive and dodge a ton. If you dodge directly opposite the way he's facing, then you have a pretty good chance to activate the Evil Harvest Rosary a couple times, and it'll just keep running into it because it'll keep trying to close the distance. It gets really hard to be aggressive with Rodin the further you get into the fight because he himself gets so aggressive later on. But now that we have changed costumes a little bit, I'm going to show you guys how to farm some halos. Actually, first I'm going to show you the phone booth cheat that I've been talking about. So I'm just going to fast forward here. You go to chapter 2 and you get up to the plaza. I think I talked about this once in an episode. And now that you're up here, you see one phone booth here. You skate over to the other one just opposite it, and then the other one is behind a pillar over here. So yeah, the Father Rodin fight is a ton of fun. He looks a bit like Father Balder, except way, way more badass. Plus, he's that strong, and he's just like, oh, I'm gonna fight you for fun. Okay, so now that I've showed off the phone books... The phone books? The phone booths. I'm going to show you something else. If you go to Chapter 7, the Temperentia boss fight, and you equip the Gaze of Despair, which enrages him, and whatever other accessory you want, and you equip Lightning Durga, you can farm him just like this. You just spam Lightning Durga over and over. Try to keep your combo score as high as possible. I've heard people getting as high as like the 800,000 to 900,000 for a complete Temperentia boss fight. Usually I come in somewhere around 400,000 to 500,000 if it's a really good fight. So you can farm halos that way. And then another thing you can do is you can go through Chapter 3, the Burning Grounds, like I just did, the very beginning. And then you skate around for a little while. Sometimes it takes a little while to pop. You want to go into the first Alfheim in Chapter 3. The first time that we have to do the Stay Off the Ground mission, where we bounce around on the angel heads. With the 5 million halos, if you farm 5 million halos the other way, you can unlock the Climax Brace, like I was saying. So you take the Climax Brace, you put that and the Gaze of Despair on so the enemies are enraged and so all your attacks are Wicked Weaves. And the same idea as Temperentia farming. You just spam the Lightning Durga because it's the fastest version, and it has a good wide reach, and the enemies here respawn infinitely. So you're never in danger of running out of things to keep your combo score multiplying. It'll max out, I think, at 9,999 times 9.9, but the combo score keeps building even after the display in the top right appears to max out. Now, I stayed alive for about 45 seconds there. That was, let's see, yeah, that was about 200,000 halos in 45 seconds, which is not even that good. If you do this well, and you survive the full 2 minutes, which is entirely possible if you're doing well, I've gotten around 5 to 6 million halos in 2 minutes farming that spot. Now, the last thing I'm going to show off in this bonus episode is the Lost Chapter Angel Slayer. And as you can see, it takes place in the Alfheim Arena. Oh, I'm going to make sure I have the right accessories on. Yep, Evil Harvest Rosary and Climax Bracelet for this one. What it is it's basically Bayonetta's equivalent to a survival mode or a horde mode. You get waves and waves of angels progressively getting stronger and stronger, and you treat it like a gauntlet. You sometimes get health pickups, but whatever health you finish the wave with is what you retain for the next one. You also get to pick up angel weapons, angel arms, and they will stay with you throughout the waves as long as you don't waste them. So, real quick, I mentioned that there is one final journal entry from Antonio Redgrave, Luca's father, that becomes unlocked once you've collected every other one in the game. And I haven't read that yet, and we haven't seen it, so I'm gonna read that right now. It is titled, "To My Beloved Son." Antonio writes, "If you find this page undestroyed and in the hands of another, that means something has happened to me. I wrote these notes in case that very if should come to pass. However, it still makes me wonder how far I will have gotten on my journey. Maybe I've been able to grasp some sort of truth from the darkness of confusion. Maybe I've been able to give my son the understanding of what it means to truly believe. To the son I love more than anything in this world. If you're the one to read this, forgive me for throwing myself into work and thinking little of our family. I am a foolish man, much too attached to my beliefs and entirely unable to change. I am sure this has caused you immeasurable trauma. Now you set off on your own journey down this long, hard road we call life. However, as a father, I have nothing I can teach you and even less I can leave you. Hopefully, you will remember the short time I spent with you as a token of my love. I pray that it will become for you a roadmap to a life of substance." Touching stuff. But with that, we have to once again close out for the final time in Bayonetta. And I'm just going to close out and leave the video playing so you can see how I actually play when I don't have to split my focus between commentating in real time and playing. So I think I fizzle out sometime toward the end, about, I don't know, 10 minutes from now. But I'm just gonna leave the video playing and close out now, because I don't really have much to say about Angel Slayer specifically. It's a fun mode. It is a good way to practice and hone your skills, especially the later levels, because they get progressively more difficult. Anyway, thanks for watching, everyone. Take it easy. Hope to see you in the next Let's Play. Take it easy. Have a good one. Thank you.
Hush! Nice! Huh!